Hey guys, Jengar here. Welcome to today's realistic review in which we are taking a look at the British Sea Meteor sitting at 7.3 beta rating. A long, long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, there was a plane known as Sea Jesus. It was a fantastic jet that could rip everything to pieces. And then Gaijin dropped the hammer, and it was crap. But the Sea Jesus has returned. It now sits at a 7.3 beta rating, gentlemen, and the Sea Jesus is back. What a difference. Oh my god, this is so much fun to fly now at the lower rank 5, that it is completely back. This plane, it is fantastic, and at the retro rating it sits now, and it's very enjoyable to fly. I pulled her out because one of my squadron mates reminded me, Maxi over there, reminded me that the Sea Meteor's battle rating had been lowered, and that indeed the Sea Jesus had returned. So we got up to it, man. We went out and we flew it and we had a lot of fun. And I had a few very nice matches, the highlight of which was this one. Now, what are the actual speeds in the Sea Meteor? It doesn't have afterburners, so you're stuck with the usual propulsion without any boosts to it. But the maximum speed in this plane at sea level without web is 808. Well, that's a red line, but let's say the rip speed, around 830. This plane accelerates so well that it can rip in a straight line, and you will eventually rip in a straight line. So it's very good that way, but you got to take it into consideration. You got to pay at least a little bit attention to where you're at the speed department if you want to go rush and take a few head-ons in the beginning of the match. At 4,500 meters, she'll go up to 726 kilometers an hour, and at 4,500 meters, she'll take you to 639. So, that is all indicated airspeed, by the way. The top speed in the dive in this plane is 808 for the red line, and then somewhere between 830 and 880 before she rips apart. But it is also possible to rip her earlier. Maneuvering with this plane, using the ailerons, maneuvering the plane, it at high speeds is very, very risky. That's why the Sea Meteor is not ideally suited for the jet style 101, which is boom and zooming, keeping her fast, keeping her straight, because the rippability of this plane is high. And in high-speed dives with maneuvers, the plane is not a shining beacon of hope, let's say that. No, she can do reasonably well in short dives, but you above 650, 700, especially, you will be in the danger zone. Especially 650 is a bit early, maybe. You really need to pull high Gs to rip her apart, but I've seen it happen. But especially above 740-ish, it becomes very possible to rip this plane. And you got to be careful of that. In a straight line though, without moving the plane at all, if you have an unmoving target, you can take her to 830, sometimes 880, depending on the angle of your dive. Steeper the angle, the sooner she rips. The control stiffening in the plane starts at 550 with a small tick in the roll rate, and at 650 you get another one, plus a little bit of elevator compression. But on the elevator it's not too terrible, but at 650 the roll rate in this plane really becomes terrible. And as you already are in approaching the rippability speed, well, not quite yet, but it is possible with high G maneuvers. You want to get out of the dive anyway, beyond 650. And because she has such fantastic acceleration in a dive and in a straight line both, by the way, you are quickly at 750 in a dive when you've already been picking up speed for a while. From 650 to 750, it won't take that long. So you got to pay attention in a dive in this plane. The stall speed in the plane is 140 kilometers an hour, which is actually quite decent. Firepower is good. The plane has four Hispano Mark IIs, I believe. God damn it, I didn't write it down this time. Well, anyway, it has 720 rounds in total. So that is actually some good ammo load on this plane. Again, I forgot to write it down this time, so forgive me for that. But you can check that out if you don't have the plane yet, what the ammo loads are per gun. It is, in any case, a very good ammo load at this battle rating. Many planes get less ammo than this plane. So yeah, she's quite competitive in the ammo load. And there has been some good changes to the belts of the Brits. I hear that the half SAPI rounds are now actually working. That is besides the fact that the ground target belts with the AP rounds also work very nicely. So the Hisparcos are not sparking so much anymore. And that is a good thing because this plane definitely felt solid in the firepower and destroying planes when I wanted them destroyed with good burst and stuff like that. So yeah, I was very pleased to see the effectiveness of the Hispanos, which, well, maybe we'll get to a point, guys, where we won't call them Hisparcos again, except from a sentimental view of the past. But it has been terrible in Brit planes, and now it seems to be improved. So let's hope that that won't be nerfed again because Brit planes suddenly start to become too good or something. The acceleration, as I said, in this plane in a straight line is excellent, as it is in a dive, also excellent. Very, very good acceleration, as I said. It's a joy, basically. That makes this plane an ideal energy fighter. It's fantastic in that role. The energy retention also helps with that. In the horizontal, the energy retention is excellent. And in the vertical, it's very good. With a climb rate, that is great. I mean, you have great power on these engines. That is fantastic. But great climb rate, very good vertical energy retention with a stall speed of 140. Very, very good in stall maneuvers and stuff like that. She's an excellent energy fighter when it comes to that. And she can also turn fight because this is one heck of a maneuverable a jet. And that is very nice. Transitioning from the energy fighting role to the turn fighting role, you can wreak havoc, basically. Turn time in the plane is good. With flaps, very good. The flaps only rip off at 530 kilometers an hour. Now that is good for a prop, but not for a jet, that rip speed on those flaps. So you have to be careful with the handling of those flaps, because if you do rip them off, it can make a difference between living and dying, or winning and losing. And you've got to be aware of that. The weakness of this plane in the maneuverability lies with the roll rate. The roll rate is average, nothing more than that. And that's unfortunate, but yeah, you got to rely on the turn rate, the sustained turn rate, not so much on the roll rate and the quick response when it comes to that. Although your reflexes can make a hell of a lot of difference when it comes to that. But overall maneuverability is good. The overheating in this plane is present, but it is definitely manageable. If you keep her at 100%, she will eventually overheat. And once you overheat, you're in trouble, just like with many jets. Once an engine is overheated, it quickly gets back to that overheated state and you're basically screwed because you constantly have to manage it then. So you want to keep it away from the red, basically, and cool her off a little bit earlier. It needs a little bit of attention, but if you do it, there's no problem, basically. The durability in the plane is below average. I would say when it gets hit in the fuselage and in some parts of the wings, it's not much worse than most. Than the average, let's say, but it's below average because of the high susceptibility to wing rips. And you really have to fly this plane disciplined. Be careful in your dives, as I said before. If you do that, though, this is a joy to fly. You just have to get the hang of her, because you cannot push her to a red line and a little bit beyond in this plane, because you are in very high risk of ripping off a wingtip, which is not cool. But I like this plane. At a 7.3 battle rating, as I said, the Sea Jesus has returned. This plane is a competitor of best plane at this battle rating, absolutely. And that is a joyful thing after all those years at an 8.0 battle rating, then a slight tick down to the 7.7, and then finally a return to a place where this plane can shine again as he used to shine. And happy days, man! Happy days for the Sea Meteor. It is fun. It is gorgeous as well, by the way. And you can land on an aircraft carrier. What more do you want? Not very useful skill, of course. But hey, sometimes you can land on a carrier here or there. That's fun. But she performs again. And she shines again. And that is good for the Sea Meteor, as it has been in a dark black hole for so long. That is absolutely, absolutely true. So yeah, I was happy to hear that. I had a lot of fun in it, and I think people, once they get it on their radar that this plane is back to its old glory days, people will be happy to fly it again. As it is, of course, one of the early planes in the Meteor line, and many of the Meteors have been way too high for way too long. But now they seem to be working on getting them back into perspective, and that will actually make it fun again to fly with some of the Meteors. Of course, you always have the Mark III, the first one, of course, which is still at 7.0. Now this one at 7.3, and some of the higher ones has also been lowered down quite a bit to 8.3, a few, I believe. So I don't know that from the top of my head, but yeah. It's a great plane, and I'm glad it's got its place back to be actually be efficient. Now, this was a nice match with nice rewards as well. The premium account I have running at right at this moment, but further, no boosters on the thing. Got a Final Blow, Survivor, the Best Squad, and Terror of the Sky. 91,000 Silver Lions and 17,000 Research Points. I'll see you in the conclusion. Hey guys, so here we are, after the match. Now, of course, it wasn't Hispano's Mark IIs. I forgot to write that down, bloody hell, and I have a memory not too great sometimes when it comes to guns and numbers and stuff like that. So I always write it down in my stat card that I make after I fly this plane and after my test flights in it to get you all the data. But it's 20mm Hispano Mark V, 780 rounds per gun, and that's quite nice, actually. But anyway, the Sea Jesus is back, and that is magnificent. It was in a black hole, as I said, for a long, long time, and it's back, and it's a joy to fly. She's a fantastic energy fighter, brilliant in the vertical, fantastic acceleration, keeps her energy well. You can energy fight most of the enemy planes at this battle rating to death. And that gives this plane a place at the top of the food chain again. Which is long, long ago when this plane shined, for the last time. And I'm glad she's back. It's fantastic. And turn fighting you can do in her as well. So what more can you ask for? Guys, I present to you the Sea Jesus. She is back. Go and fly her. Have fun. And remember old times. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button, become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video, do leave me a comment, and if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.